Earth does not orbit the Sun. Atomic theory is wrong. In fact, Newton was wrong. Newtonian mechanics, not correct. At least if we're talking about truth and the way things really are. Now, when I say that the Earth does not orbit the Sun, well, technically, any body in space moves relative to any other body. The Earth and the Sun co-orbit each other. The center of this co-orbit is just a little closer to the Earth than the center of the Sun itself, simply because the Sun outweighs the Earth by so much. And if you want to visualize this, imagine getting two tennis balls tied together on a string and flip it into the air, and you'll actually see them do this kind of motion like this. That is like what a binary star does. And this is two bodies orbiting each other in space. And that's what the Earth and the Sun are doing, except in the case of the Earth and the Sun, imagine one of them being a bowling ball and the other one being a ping pong ball. And if you were to flip it in the air, you'd find that the ping pong ball is spinning around the bowling ball. They're also co-orbiting, but because the bowling ball weighs so much more, the actual center of rotation is much closer to the bowling ball's center. Same for the Earth and the Sun. So, the Earth does not orbit the Sun, they co-orbit each other. Think about atomic theory. We know that the atomic theory that you learn, or the atomic stuff that you learn in school, you know, the periodic table of elements, there's protons, neutrons, electrons, that's wrong. We know it's wrong. Quantum mechanics says it's wrong. Experimental evidence has shown it's wrong. It's a reasonable approximation. It's good enough to get you the idea. And it works for a lot of things. But it's not correct. It's just a rough approximation. And the same goes for Newtonian mechanics. Newtonian mechanics, velocity is equal to acceleration times time, force equals mass times acceleration, distance equals 1/2 acceleration times time squared, blah blah blah. All these formulas, rough approximations, because they do not take special relativity into account. And the fact that moving bodies actually change in time relative to each other, and you notice this effect once the speeds get really high. The Newtonian calculations do not take this into account. Now, for the speeds that we deal with around here on Earth, Newtonian mechanics are in general enough. But all we have to do is go into space with, say, the satellites, specifically the GPS satellites, and we learn that Newtonian mechanics is wrong. It's not enough. We need to get into special relativity and time slew. The reason why I'm bringing all this stuff up is these are three things: orbit of the Earth, atomic theory, Newtonian mechanics, that are taught in school that we know are wrong. They're gross oversimplifications or crude approximations of what's actually true. And as you get up in higher grades in school or in university, you actually start to learn more about what we know. You learn the more precise sciences behind these things. But it's enough for school kids to get a picture. But what I find interesting is that we know these things are wrong, and yet we teach them in school, and I never hear any religious people complaining about the fact that we are teaching these wrong things to kids, and we know they're wrong. We know that they're approximations, but they don't complain about that. They complain about evolution. Evolution, counter to quantum, you know, Newtonian mechanics, the planetary mechanics, and the atomic theory. Evolution is true. It's correct. You learn some of it in school, and you learn more of it when you get to university, but you don't learn a different thing. You don't learn, what you learned in school was wrong. That was a gross oversimplification. Here's a different thing entirely. Because, you know, string theory and quantum mechanics are nothing like the atomic stuff that you learn in school. Whereas the evolution that you learn in university is just a progression of the same thing, as opposed to a replacement. So it's interesting that Christians complain about evolution, something that that is taught in school and we know is right, and they do not complain about planetary mechanics, Newtonian motion, and atomic theory, stuff that we teach in school and we know is wrong. Why do you suppose that would be?